So I'm a week into being in Antarctica, and I can say I'm definitely feeling a little bit more exhausted with each day because I keep pushing it farther and further. It's around midnight tonight, and I've been in the lab all day. Today, I think I finally got my lab space finally set up. I've got about half a dozen microscopes, camera adapters, macro photography set up, and I'm really excited about it. Finally, now I'm getting to see all the creepy crawlies that I came here to actually see with my microscopes and my cameras. It's just kind of 24/7 science around here, and it's kind of awesome. The sea ice reaches its farthest extent in September, nearly doubling the size of the Antarctic continent. I joined a few Antarctic divers helping me collect samples of microbes living within this frozen ocean to go see the life under the ice for myself.
A waterproof seal on my wrist, and when I put this on, I'll have a waterproof seal on my neck, so water theoretically doesn't get into the suit. And then you wear lots of warm undergarments.
Oh my gosh, that's a long way down.
Yeah, so like I said, I think it's 74 or 76 foot deep here.
Go down under the hole, pin off, and just remember to spin into the hole.
Yep. Rob's going to demonstrate.
Cold seated entry.
Gone.
Next, it was my turn to see why anyone would want to dive into such a bitterly cold frozen ocean. Thankfully, it didn't require me to wear a dry suit. The observation tube, also known as the ob tube, is a long metal pipe inserted into the sea ice that allows anyone to go behind the 9 feet thick ice curtain. So I'm here inside the observation tube. I am literally sitting in the ocean beneath the ice, which is the coolest thing. And it's hard to see me because it's so dark down here, but you can see the ice up here behind me, and I am just surrounded by fish. And occasionally I'm hearing the sound of a seal or other creatures around here, which is just so cool. This is probably the coolest thing in McMurdo Station. This is just amazing to be in this tiny little tube, just sitting beneath the ice. This is definitely life under the ice, and getting up and close and personal with it is just an incredible experience. After that mind-blowing experience, I headed to the aquarium at Crary Lab to pick up the microbes that the divers collected for me. Crary Lab is where many of the Antarctic scientists work and collaborate on amazing research. I was given an office and my very own lab space for the first time in my life.
I honestly could barely contain how excited I was to have a lab.
One of the things that I think is the absolute coolest feature here in Curry Lab in McMurdo Station is the fact that they have seawater on tap. They have a hose that's pulling in seawater constantly, and you can just use it for your science experiments. For me personally, I'm using it to filter out different microbes and keep them in the seawater that they're all happy living in. So definitely an awesome feature about this lab. I finally got one of my microscopes up and running, cleaned it fully, and put in a little bit of a sample in it from that I got from a diver here. And my heart just began fluttering because it was so awesome to begin seeing all these little creepy crawlies begin to move around and actually seeing my project that I'm down here for come to life, pun intended. It just, I couldn't put it into words how happy I was. I've worked so long and so hard to get to this point where I can actually begin looking at all these critters here in Antarctica under the microscope, and today it has started and I'm so excited to share it all with you.
On the next episode, I travel to the dry valleys to witness some of the most breathtaking natural features that are home to some pretty hardcore microbes. You can support this project, become one of my official space friends, and get some fun stuff in the mail by heading on over to my Patreon. Thanks to all my awesome patrons, and a special shout out to the ones listed in the YouTube description below. You're amazing. Thanks also to the National Science Foundation Antarctic Artists and Writers Program, the San Francisco Microscopical Society, National Geographic, and the many Antarctic researchers, friends, and colleagues of mine who helped this project come to life.